Coming to Northeast Wisconsin live from the Civic Media Studios and featuring TV and radio broadcast veteran John Mino, along with the City of Green Bay's longest serving mayor, Jim Schmidt. This is Mino and the Mayor. Here are your hosts, John Mino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back. Mino the Mayor here on a beautiful Wednesday morning. Special thanks to Ben and Deanna Malcor, Bay Area Realty. You know, you and I are both talking about getting our license again. Wouldn't you love it if Deanna taught the class?
Yeah. I mean, she knows what she's talking about, and she's so easy to listen to, and yeah, confident.
Mm-hmm. And personable, and I think, the whole thing.
Well, we renew our license in realtors, and a reminder for you realtors out there, every 2 years, you got to renew your license. So you got till December, but I think we're going to do that.
Grace, you looking for a place we can help you out with?
Ooh, not right now.
Okay,
still renting.
Okay, that's enough for you, Grace.
And if you ever want to sell the Croc Center, let us know.
Lisa, you looking to sell your house in Howard?
Nope, not
okay,
yet.
Okay, all right, thanks. Well, right, okay, bro. Let's move on.
Okay.
Lisa Prunty, Simple Life Hospitality. She does the marketing and PR. How much fun was that yesterday?
Yeah, and Lisa put on this great event yesterday. There's a house that Simple Life Hospitalities manages, and it's right on True Lane. You can see
2014 it's and 2016.
It's right in the shadows of Lambeau Field, and they manage that. And the people.
And when you
who
say that, we're not kidding. The sun was coming up over the rim of Lambeau Field and reflecting right into the window where we were sitting.
Yeah, and the people. Beautiful. And the people who own the home stopped in as well, and they just love Simple Life Hospitality. They're like, you guys are you're doing it right. You're getting the right tenants. It's not, you know, you do the background checks, the security and everything else, and get them top dollar, too.
And we're going to have a guy on. We're talking on Sheboygan Falls that made national news, an Airbnb. Two drunk guys destroyed it.
Yeah.
Destroyed it.
Intentionally destroyed it.
Yeah.
And which is sad.
It is, and had they gone with you, that wouldn't have happened.
Exactly.
But and you have, you know, over 100 homes that you manage, and you're going to have 101 pretty soon, as soon as I get my license. But I just think it's great that people can use that. And you're providing a great service to this community, because we don't want to happen what happened to those guys in Sheboygan. And I think people, the other thing, you were there pretty much all day yesterday, but the fines, if you don't follow the rules, are $2,500.
Right.
That's a lot of money.
It is a lot of money. And to make the investment up front with either a company such as Simple Life or another company, but to protect yourself and to just protect the area that you live in, it's a bonus.
And then the inspector said, too, that there's got to be someone within 30 minutes of your property just in case something happens.
I have volunteered to be that guy.
Yeah. But they need somebody who's knowledgeable within 30 minutes of your property. And, you know, we might be gone. So, I mean, Simple Life's going to check that box for us, too. So, anyway, thanks for bringing that
idea. You're going to have to get somebody, right? Aren't you staying in?
They do it.
But I mean, that's what I mean. You're not going to be within 30 minutes.
Simple Life team will be within 30 minutes.
Right.
There'll be several of us working and making sure that everything's taken care of. But first of all, thanks for yesterday.
Yeah,
and,
fun.
You know, it's not only me, it's a team. It takes a team to put on what we did yesterday. A lot of moving parts, a lot of moving people through the door, and even, you know, preparing for the week before. So it's a team effort by everybody. So thanks to the Simple Life team and to Todd and all of you guys, too. It's great.
Yeah,
Todd did a lot of fun.
No.
I mean,
is he there?
I don't even know. Was he there?
I don't know.
So anyway, we're going to give away some stuff. We had some drawings.
Yes.
So go ahead and take it from there.
So we have a Hy-Vee $200 gift card for the meat department. I believe that's what it says.
Nice.
And that is going to Kathy Tilot.
Sorry, Jim.
Kathy Tilot was walking through our home yesterday, and she is going to be potentially renting her home in Brussels for the draft.
All right. So, Kathy.
Yeah. Super, super sweet lady.
How did it turn out for you guys as far as getting new clients?
It worked really well. Between 4 and 6, they were quite busy. We were a little worried after the storm, but we did have people come. People are interested. They want to know. They want to know the good, bad, and ugly.
Great.
So awesome. That was great.
All right, Kathy,
And then we have the $50 gift card from Circle K and some goodies. And that went to Faylene Van.
Okay.
And she's also looking at renting out her home, and she's in De Pere. Sounds like it.
That's Brussels, De Pere. All right.
Yeah.
We're
so, you know, still,
we
still
like
in
that.
Distance.
Right.
And then your M&Ms are going to John Schwarzenbart. So John stopped in to say hi to us, and he's going to get his M&Ms.
Great.
So, well, thank you for having a great
show. The
M&Ms
you brought back from New York. We auctioned those off. We raffled them off.
Okay, I'm hearing about it now. Okay, how do I give those away to my kids, my grandkids?
Do I need to give them back to you? I can give them back to you.
That's fine. That's awesome.
Actually,
that's
what is the M&M package? I don't know what that one
it's
is.
It's just a thing of M&Ms.
Oh, the big huge
and,
thing.
Yeah, and I know this person, so I can deliver them. I don't have to put them in the mail, and they won't melt.
Outstanding.
So,
Lisa, thank you so much for what you guys doing. Yeah. Simple Life Hospitality. We had a great time out there.
Yeah, we did too.
And I can't wait for our next remote.
I can't wait for the next one.
We'll have more to come on that. Right up your alley, smoked salmon.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, all right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Lisa.
Santa Mike.
Let's talk to Grace Hagerman from the Croc Center. Got a great event coming up, International Community Festival. Yeah. Hi.
Hi. Thank you so much for having me on. I'm so excited.
Well, like I said, I did the thing with you on Channel 5 on Lisa Malick's show, and it's like, I got to get her on our radio show.
That's right.
Because you do a great job. Go ahead and tell us all about it.
Yeah, so
and again, Jim and I were both there when they broke ground.
You know, and that place is just such a service to our community. You know, I mean, it's really a great facility for, and it's just top end. You know, you just really didn't. You know, the wood bullnose, just everything there is so state of the art. It's like a rich man's country club, you know? I mean, it's just really, really a great place and the activities you offer there.
And ironically, though, it's built for disadvantaged kids and everything.
They're lower income.
That's the cool part of it.
It is. That's what I'm saying. They can do that. International Community Festival. So this is your third year. So tell us about it.
Yeah. So our International Community Festival is really a celebration of diversity in Northeastern Wisconsin. I mean, we are so lucky to live in a community where there's so many cultures represented. There's so many people that move to live here from around the world. And this is a really great time to highlight all of those different groups of people. So we have from the Belgian Heritage Center out in Luxembourg, they're coming. We also have Casa Alba, Melanie, they're coming. And so we have a whole range of things that we're offering. We have performances, we have storytelling, we have food trucks. So it's been really
wonderful. Do you have a Belgian food truck?
No, not necessarily.
What would be Belgian food?
Pastries?
Yeah, probably.
Kolaches?
Right? Yeah. Well, I'd be more Polish, but yeah. But you have some cooking demonstrations too, which would be cool for kids, adults.
Yep. So right now we're planning on having some of our tables are going to be offering pastries. So some of our vendors are going to be offering some free samples and showing what how those processes are made, how those items are made. So it's going to be really cool.
And this is kind of a festival to bring all these different entities, for lack of a better word, together, right?
Yes, cultures together. But what's cool about this is that, and this is for everybody, mom, dad, kids. I mean, they can all learn something.
Yeah, absolutely. And also, on top of all the things we're offering, you know, all of the fun activities, all the people that you can meet, all the different resources you can learn from, it's also a free day at the Croc from 1 to 5. So
people can
come and swim in the pool. Our gym necessarily won't be open because all the booths will be in the gym. But if you want to come work out, you can come.
I told you this before. That is the greatest basketball gym in Northeast Wisconsin.
How about that water park?
Yeah, it's Wisconsin-Dellsworthy,
it
for
is,
sure.
That's a great water park. And, you know, the other things, you have a lot of stuff there, too. I mean, you have like you said, the gym is great, but, you know, there's other art rooms. And talk a little bit more about the facility. I don't know if everybody's been there, but, I mean, your health club, and it's free that day from 1 to 5 to experience that. But if you haven't been to the Croc Center, which is very easy to find, you know, right on Bellevue Street, right across from JBS, easy, you get plenty of parking there. Tell us a little bit more what's inside that beautiful looking building.
Yeah, so we have such a range of things that we can offer. I mean, of course, we have our health and our lifestyle side with our fitness, our gym, our pool, but then we also have a huge fine arts program where we can offer dance, we do painting, there's a whole clay studio.
Music,
yep, we have music labs as well, so we have piano, guitar, and right now I think we're going to be offering drums pretty soon. So we have a really huge range of programming that we can offer to both kids and adults, and then we also have our Croc Church, if that's interesting, on Sundays. We're closed on Sundays, but Croc has our church. We have a whole range
of people, when I had my granddaughters a couple of weeks ago, and we're looking for some things to do, can you get, like, day passes for the water park and things?
Oh, yeah, people do that all the time. It's really cool, so they can a lot of people do come just to get a day pass to go to the pool. We have a range of day passes available if people want to come to the pool. People can also get them to go work out if that's something that they want to do, if they want to go play basketball in the gym. That's always awesome.
And you offer some pretty competitive, very competitive memberships too. Mm-hmm. Like to use your facility. And what I like your treadmills. You have some of the best treadmills because you can program them for where you want to run, and to run through Italy is cool to see that, and to just different areas. I think that's pretty neat. And even
hard to figure out though.
But John just looks at a black screen. But the most of us know how to just hit two buttons. But it's cool because when you go up the hill, it goes up
does it really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't know that. It goes with the
terrain. You didn't get the experience.
I did not.
When you go down the hill,
Wow.
Anyway, you got a lot of cool equipment there, I guess is what I'm saying.
Thank Thank you. Yeah. Also, we have for scholarships for people. So that's always something that people can apply to get different rates off of their membership pricing. We do family memberships. We have group memberships. Also, if you are a corporate connections partner, which is free for corporations to join, you get a discount on your membership there if you are part of that corporation. So like JBS is a corporate connections. And so a lot of their employees get discounts, which is really cool.
And I still think, I mean, I still remember this from the day of the grand opening, mm-hmm. and Joan Kroc, mm-hmm. and the story, it's really a heartwarming type story. I mean, here she's a billionaire, however many times over, okay? And
just for the record, Kroc is McDonald's.
Yeah, the old McDonald's, yeah. Yep. But she wanted this because when she was young, in San Diego, I think it was, very disadvantaged family, and all her rich friends were going to the country clubs, mm-hmm. and the whatever, and she always felt so left out, mm-hmm. that she said, if I ever have the money, I'm going to make something accessible to kids like the type of kid I was. Right. So, I mean, you talk about something from the heart.
No, she's
That's
great.
Really quite the story.
Family.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's a really interesting process of what happened because there's really only like 26 of them in the country. So we're very lucky to have one within our Green Bay community. But yeah, so part of our funding comes from the Kroc Foundation. And that's how we run, is McDonald's money.
Exactly.
Well, I do want to say that was very competitive to get that here.
Yes.
There was a lot of people vying for that. And I just want to give kudos to our community again. They stepped up with, I think, $7 million towards that. And yeah, that was a big lift just for Green Bay, but they all understood that disadvantaged kids need as much, opportunity as kids that came from maybe middle class. So it was a real partnership, and I'm glad it's so successful. And this event's going to be cool for families to go to and see it all. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm hoping that everyone that can come out, what does come out. We have a lot of fun things.
When and where, one more time, please.
It's at the Kroc Center on Limekiln Road at September 28th from 1 to 5.
Yeah. Limekiln. I said Philadelphia. I was one street off. It's Limekiln.
That's what this weekend.
That's September 28th.
Oh, September 28th.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Today's the 28th.
We can plug this again. No, we got time. We got time.
September 28th.
Yeah, and that's, and people should talk about it. People should, and from 1 to 5, definitely, but I mean, it goes all day.
So the event itself is only from 1 to 5.
Oh, 1
and
to 5.
Also, that's the free time of
right.
when people can come access.
I think that's cool to try it out.
How much would your, for a guy like my age, how much would it be for a thing?
Well, it really would depend. I mean, a lot of insurance programs for seniors, sorry.
Seniors.
Wow. A lot of insurance programs cover it.
I wouldn't qualify, right?
Why did you throw that out?
I know.
Don't want to. Sorry.
There's great programs that they offer a variety of things. And
it's a phenomenal place. Yeah. I can't say a single thing again. I worked out there for a while. And
one day. But anyway,
I did a lot more than one day.
I like your events for kids, the art and the music.
Thank
I think
you.
That's cool too. And yeah, there's a lot of places maybe to work out, but the two things I would check for kids is your pool is like the best.
That's
I mean,
awesome.
That just is like
basketball.
One of the best.
You want to play pickup basketball?
Yeah.
Phenomenal.
That's cool.
No question. Grace, thank you so very much.
There,
you're doing a great
thank
job
you.
There.
Thank you.
Grace Hageman, Kroc Center International Community Festival coming up on September 28th. We'll be back with more right after this. Hey, welcome back. My name is the Mayor here on a Wednesday morning, 67 at Green Bay, 68 in Appleton, 71 in Oshkosh. Special thanks today to Len Nelson for the fundraiser for Rick McNeil, Ben and Deanna Malcor, Bay Area Realty, always fun. Lisa Prunty from Simple Life Hospitality. That's a great company if you're looking to rent out your home. Grace Hageman just now from the Kroc Center International and Community Festival Day coming up. And we've got Terry Barr coming up. Slice of Wisconsin in just a few minutes. Other things that we didn't mention, Leanne Rimes' birthday today, 42 years old. Jake Owen is 43.
I don't know either one of them.
Country.
Oh, Leanne Rimes. Her first hit was called Blue.
It was
back
huge.
In the day. She was 13 years old.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And they thought she was going to be like the next Loretta Lynn.
Yep.
Remember that?
Yep.
And she did okay. Had some weird behind the scenes kind of stuff. Yep. And
like with drugs or relationships or what?
Relationships.
Oh.
Yeah. Jack Black is 55. Jason Priestley is 55. Shania Twain, I've always loved Shania Twain, is 59. Scott Hamilton, the figure skater, is 66.
Shania is a little weird. I remember doing a meet and greet with her, listeners of the station.
Where?
Toledo, Ohio.
Oh.
And she did not want to be touched. And she, they literally had marks on the floor so that they were a certain distance away from her. Diva. She didn't want to be anywhere.
I went to her concert at the Resch, and I was talking to one of the security guys, and it was kind of one of those things where don't look at her when she walks. Like, don't, like, go eye to eye.
Yeah.
Type of thing.
I just.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate they make it because there's so many people who are just really, really good people that are super talented, and none of these divas make it. Yeah. Anyway.
Yeah.
Who's that lady that I met with the Dalai Lama? What's her name? She was a little bit like
Taylor
that.
Swift?
No.
Did you meet Taylor Swift?
No.
Oh.
Mm-mm.
Who was the woman that you always tell us about?
Yeah.
The Dalai Lama.
Let's go, girls.
Ah. I don't know now.
She's different. She dresses weird.
Oh, I know. Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga.
Oh,
Lady Gaga.
Oh, that's right.
I mean, she was nicer. She had a little bit of an act, but she did. She shook my kid's hand, and that's all
that's
I cared about.
Cool.
I didn't want to, I didn't care less about her. Yeah. I didn't know who she was till Laura pointed her out.
I still think Todd wins the award for most interesting meeting with a very famous musician.
Yeah.
Madonna.
Yeah.
She was all over him.
Yeah. It was an interesting
party. Funny I missed that story.
Huh?
Oh.
You heard that story.
Oh, yeah. In Kalamazoo?
I may have been reading.
No, this was down in Mississippi.
Oh, I thought that one was Kalamazoo for some reason.
The story changes.
Okay. Tell the story, Todd.
Well, she had her new album, Music, come out in, I think, 2000. And there was a record station party.
Okay.
A record label party.
Which they used to have.
All the time.
Yeah.
These people would come to town, you know, even like John Mayer comes to town brand new. The record company's like, I'll take you out to dinner. And then they want you to go, okay, I'll add that record next
absolutely.
Week. Right?
So absolutely.
That's basically what was going on here. And somebody said, well, this is Todd Michaels. He's with Y101, and they're the first station that's playing your new single.
To Madonna. Wow.
And she gestured to me. That's all I want to say.
Okay.
But there was a grabbing of me, and then, you know. Mm-hmm.
Really, a sexual gesture to Todd Michaels from Madonna.
Yes. That sounds like Casey Kasem. And now,
a sexual
dedication from Madonna to Todd Michaels.
Well, that's cool.
Todd, remember that night in Mississippi?
I'm assuming it was positive that it was.
Well,
yeah.
Funny how you look at it.
Yeah.
You know, I was 24 years younger.
It was positive.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely. But that's,
and did
that's
you? So she didn't answer your follow up calls, or what happened? What happened? Well, how come that? Well, how come you were an item?
As soon as the party was done, she was gone, and she didn't.
You know what I regret? You know what I regret? Who I could have met as? I heard she's a real diva too, though. But I could have met Cher.
Oh yeah,
because they wanted. Remember Dan Stone? Hey John, I can't.
When she was here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Could you? Would you introduce Cher?
And
it's like, and then do the meet and greet. And it's like, wow. But then I had something going on Packer-wise or whatever it was.
And that's a lot of work. People don't think
people don't
it
realize
is,
it, yeah.
But making sure all your people are backstage and they're behaving themselves.
Len and I could have sat here and told stories for half an hour about hosting listeners for meet and greets. And the worst part is sometimes at the last minute, hey, guys, sorry, we have to cancel the meet and greet. And you've done these contests.
Yep.
And the listeners are so excited. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
And they got their cameras ready and they're dressed like, you know, the whole thing is, sorry, so-and-so isn't feeling well and you can't do it. And then who do they blame?
Right.
You.
Yeah.
Yep.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. We did that meet and greet with Coach McCarthy. With Don and I went with him and his wife to Sugarland?
Sugarland, okay.
He was a huge Sugarland. And it was
he's a huge country fan.
Their dressing room was this office is bigger than their dressing room.
Really?
We
the Resch?
Yeah, we went into this maybe it was a different room. But anyway, we went in and I just thought, well, this is a little cozy. But yeah, and the same deal. But it was nice and it was put on. I don't know who put it on, but those are special and I can see somebody.
Oh, you know what?
Really
I think I know what room that would be. Because that used to when I was doing the GB basketball games, Coach Kowalczyk and I would leave the locker room and go into that room.
Yeah.
And we would do the interviews.
Yeah,
I know
right
what you mean.
Before they went on stage, so we just talked to them. But anyway, those meet and greets are those are cool, and I can see somebody being very disappointed if they're canceled.
Was that
and they
Jennifer Nettles, Sugarland? Was that Jennifer Nettles?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Yeah, neither. I did,
but I think he did something for the Kenny Chesney concert too. I think he walked on stage, gave him a jersey or something like everybody always does.
Yeah.
But you know who was a really cool guy that you think maybe wouldn't be was Kid Rock.
Oh yeah,
he was. Totally. I brought him a T-shirt that I'd gotten in Afghanistan and said something about Afghanistan rock band or something like that. He took a picture with me, did whatever. He was super cool with all the people.
Yeah.
But I hate it when people big time their fans. You know, especially Especially, I shouldn't even say this, but especially when they're kind of on the way down.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Right. When they're playing up in, nothing against Escanaba, but they're playing in Escanaba instead of Las Vegas.
Or at a couple other places I could mention. You know,
Fair, it's like, County
okay,
Fair.
Right. It's like, okay.
Yeah.
I'm here. And
yeah. 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 Don't. And you got to remember, those are your most loyal fans.
Right.
Right.
Right. They've paid money to come see you.
Exactly.
Right.
I know.
Exactly.
Yeah, I got my tickets this morning, and it doesn't like this.
Yeah,
I think, but and some people are very appreciative. But yeah, it's, I don't know, these actors, entertainers, it's really nice when they're super nice people.
Exactly.
You know? And so Madonna, yes or no, she was nice, or what is she?
Oh,
I don't know anything
great.
About her.
Okay. I mean, she was great.
Cool.
You know.
All right. My only, I told you.
She wasn't real big yet then, right?
No. This was after she was real big. This
it
was her this was her resurgence in 2000.
Wow. Okay.
That's Kudos. Pretty cool. Yeah. I'm sure you got photos to back
She was a cougar to you.
Wow. This was the big song that came out that we were trying to play on the radio.
Oh, I don't remember this.
Right? Yeah,
exactly.
Okay. Who Nobody. Was yours? Big time to you?
Well, I had a lot of them, but
give us one.
You had one at the whatchamacallit out here.
Carlton,
the
right?
Carlton.
A lot of them. I mean, I don't remember which one.
But there was one that surprised me.
Jerry Lewis?
No, I've heard that about him numerous times. Yeah.
yes, he is. I love it. I have to think.
It was somebody's like, really? I wouldn't expect her. It was a woman. I wouldn't expect her to be that way. I don't.
Dionne Warwick?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, yes. She was not in a good mood. And,
all right.
Yeah.
All right, we got to take a quick break.
She never moved
Before
off.
Before I put on my
she
makeup.
She never moved off the stool. I mean, you didn't want to work a crowd, go stage side to side, entertain them. She sat on the stool the whole night, just locked in our spotlights, sat there.
Well, Warren Gertz tells a story about when Marty Robbins was in town. That's all he did was complain about the sheriff's department in Green Bay because of some, the whole time. Right. And people are like, shut up and sing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Terry Burr, Slice of Wisconsin, coming up.
And while riding, I think of us, dear. I say a little prayer for you. At work, I just take time. And all through my coffee break time.
With a friend, check out the Mino and the Mayor podcast at civicmedia.us and on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. Take Mino and the Mayor with you everywhere. Now, once again, Mino and the Mayor, John Mino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back. Mino and the Mayor here on a kind of overcast.
No, that's not going to happen here.
Boy, a lot of power outages around the area yesterday and different areas. That
really was unbelievable at like 11 o'clock, 10 after 11. In the morning, that was
got
quite
so
the storm.
Dark. It was incredible.
That was cool.
Incredible. Is Terry Barr? Oh, we've got Terry Barr.
All right. The Slice of Wisconsin.
Hello, Terry Barr.
Hello, boys.
How are you?
How are you? And hello, everyone in Northeast Wisconsin.
I was thinking of you the other day. I had, sometimes I put my thing, I know how to do this, on Google, songs from eras. And I did mid-60s songs.
Mm-hmm.
And,
60s.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like the oldies. And I thought of you because there was a big time singer named, I can't think of her name. It wasn't Barr. She did this song. Will it please be him? Dear God, it must be him. But it must be him.
No.
Vicky Carr.
Oh, Vicky Carr.
Vicky Carr.
It must be him.
Okay. It must be him.
All right. Yeah. All right.
From Ed Sullivan Show.
So Vicky Carr turned into Terry Barr.
Yes.
Oh yeah, that's interesting.
Okay,
yes.
Every time I hear Vicky Carr, I think of Terry Barr.
Exactly.
Totally. That's the rest of
that. That's a nice stretch.
Northeast Wisconsin.
But then they had a thing with Johnny Cash, and he was introducing her and said, "Are you far, Vicky Carr?" And I was going to do that for you. Are you far, Terry Barr?
Oh, okay, yes, you can sing that to me every Wednesday
No, we already had the birthday song.
We're done
with Mino. So.
What is going on in the state of Wisconsin, Terry Barr?
Well, I have something special for you today. You've probably heard we started this new program for Northeast Wisconsin called New Wisco Weekend.
Yes.
And it's on every Saturday and Sunday morning, and we are having so much fun with this. And you may or may not know you're part of the show just because you're Northeast Wisconsin. So that's pretty cool. But we asked an editor from Up North News to quickly give us the top three in-state spots to go right now. Just a quick travel. If you want to hop in the car and go have some fun, where should you go? Well, number three, the
Dells. Let us guess.
Okay.
You want to guess, Jenny?
Number three.
What do you say?
What's number three?
Well, I'm going to say. Number three.
She just said it.
I already gave you the answer. The Dells.
Oh, the Dells. Oh,
which
okay,
is cool. I would pick that as definitely the top five. I mean, the Dells is awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
So what do you think? I'm skipping number two for a minute, but what would
Lambeau?
You guess would be number one?
It's got to be Lambeau. Is it Green Bay?
No.
Okay, just wait. Let me guess.
I like. She went off the board for this one. Way off the board.
I know what it is. It's House on a Rock.
No.
We already had this discussion. No one's been to House on the Rock.
I have many times.
Everybody has. We did a survey. We did a survey. That was last year.
Todd, you ever go to House on the Rock?
Yes, sir. Everybody's been there. Just wait. I got to think about Wisconsin. So it's got to be in Milwaukee.
No.
Really?
Yeah. Okay, it's Warren's for Cranberry Festival, or to just go there and get anything you can that's made from cranberries.
Where?
Warren's.
I don't believe
that. Warren, Wisconsin? One. Is that a name of a town?
Yes.
I've never heard of it.
This. Oh, my gosh. This is a little city in Cranberry Country, 3,000 people, but during Cranberry Festival, 150,000 people.
Wow. Where is tell us about Cranberry. Where is this
Where's
town?
Warren?
I don't know. Yeah.
But now I have to get back to number two for you.
Okay.
Warren's, you know, is all around Stevens Point and probably a little more northwest.
Okay.
Yeah, because Stevens Point, Wausau, all of that area is considered Cranberry Country.
Well, you know, that's our Brittany Merlot. That's her territory.
Right. How about number two?
Yeah, there you go. Okay.
How about
what do you think would be number two?
The Shrine.
Between the Dells and Warren's.
The Shrine.
What Shrine?
The Shrine and Champion.
Oh, the chapel.
Yeah. No?
Nope.
Where is it between what?
It's Green Bay. It is.
Oh,
number
it is
two
Bay.
Is Green Bay.
Okay.
Yep. But get this. She said not for the Packers or Lambeau Field.
Bay Beach.
Mr. Mayor, you're going to love this.
I am.
Bay Beach.
Yeah, I know. That's cool. Love
it. Statewide?
Love it. Bay
number
Beach.
Number two, Green Bay. She said, and try to go not for the Packers or Lambeau. There's so many other things to do, and she loves Bay Beach.
Wow.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
And that's
for the
so
whole state. Yep.
Great
so
family.
So now, I don't
affordable.
Know, Todd, yep. Should we cue the song that goes along with Bay Beach?
Yeah. Do you want to give any preface to this, or should I just play it, and then you can
There's
talk
a song
about
that
it afterwards?
Goes along with Bay Beach.
Yeah, you know, okay, so there is a Wisconsin-based musician, but he tours internationally. He wrote an entire album about Bay Beach.
Did you know that, Jim?
I don't know. I don't think I did. No, I...
Okay.
When did it come out?
Just a couple of years ago, within the last 5 years.
Okay.
All right, I say well, we play this.
We
what
have
do you think?
To, absolutely.
Yeah, we hear it.
I love this so much. I hope you will too.
Okay,
check this out.
Ode to Bay Beach.
All the Red Devils and the Fighting Trojans meet at the Bay Beach to feel the motion of the Zipper. Yeah, the Zipper Pipper. It'll zip you to the left, zip you to the right. Zipper Pipper. Clickety clack up the hill you. Then drop you like a meteor out of the sky.
I like it.
It'll zip you to the left, zip you to the right, zip on people.
That's cool.
You gotta feel pretty
wow.
Great about that.
The girls all scream.
It's actually good music.
That is good
it
music.
Is good.
Wow. Wow, that guy studied it.
That was phenomenal.
Love it. That was awesome. I can't believe I haven't heard that. That is great.
I can't believe how detailed he got.
Right. That's he did his research, right?
He's got to do one more verse, though, about the mayor that brought the Zip and Pippin to Green Bay. That would make Jim happy. Yeah.
Can we get him on the show? Yeah. We got to get him on the show.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's Trapper amazing. Shep. He is based in Milwaukee, but proud to say he is internationally touring and he is doing terrific. But he has a soft spot for Bay Beach and, yes, did an entire album about all the rides at Bay Beach. But his favorite is also Zip and Pippin.
That was amazing.
Wow. That was really, really good.
I mean, I'm not kidding.
That's good music, too. It wasn't like corny. It was like, I would listen to that. And yeah, that was great. Well, I'd love to get him on the show. I'd like to meet him. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
So he
thank him, I should say. Yeah,
he just came here like, guys, that was a great song to do the twist to.
Yeah.
So he just comes here as a tourist. You know what I mean? What's his okay?
He actually, and I was disappointed I didn't know this soon enough, but he did a show at Bay Beach about a month ago.
Oh.
Hmm. Yeah, he travels everywhere. He is one of those musicians where he'll play anywhere, anytime. He can play solo. He has a duo, and then he's got the full band. So one of those. But I think a long time ago, he heard the story of the Zip and Pippin. And, you know, as any good musician will do, they'll go figure out the story, then go check out the actual thing. And he was so enamored with it. He said, I had to write a song not just about it, and the history and bringing it to Green Bay. But then also he said, oh my gosh, this is the cutest place ever. So thus became an album.
What was the thing about Elvis before he died?
He rode that. There's a sign out there. Yeah, he rode that thing before he died. Oh yeah. He used to rent that thing out. It was Liberty Land was like their Bay Beach down in Memphis. And he would just, it's not that far really from Graceland. And he would just take his friends out there and they'd operate it all night and just keep riding it. I think right the night before or something, very close to his death, he had ridden it.
That's amazing.
Well,
that's
Trapper had an interesting thing that he learned from Memphis. Elvis rode it for several hours that one particular night. Just did not get off of the ride, kept going around and around and around. And finally, I guess somebody said, okay, we need to shut it down. So there's the top part where you're going to go down the hill, the real high part. Mm-hmm. Elvis jumped off. And so when the ride came down for its stop, he was not on it.
Where was he?
He was standing up on top.
Yeah. Okay, he jumped out, not off.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah. Wow.
Okay, he jumped out.
Isn't that kind of creepy?
That is.
Wow.
That's pretty cool, though. Yeah. Okay. Wow.
Yep.
I think
wow.
Yeah.
How did we not know about this? Todd?
Well, that's why Terry Barr is here this morning. Because
wow, that's a real slice of Wisconsin.
That was
so
fantastic,
cool.
Terry.
I mean, it really is. Wow. Yeah,
we dug deep for that one, but I'm so glad we did.
Absolutely.
Oh, so precious.
So, this survey was the number two was Bay Beach, three was the Dells, and then number one was...
No, number one was Cranberries.
No, I'm saying Warren. Yeah. Was Warren, Wisconsin.
Yep.
Do they have a festival coming up? I'd like to see that, if that's number one
attraction
in Wisconsin.
Yeah, they do. In September, they have the huge Cranberry Festival is in September. You can go to the bogs. They'll be working in the bogs. And, there you go. There would be a visit for you to do.
The John would go to the bongs. The bogs? What is that?
Between the two of us, Panama Red?
September 27th is the event, Warren's Cranberry Festival.
You know, they say there's nothing better for you than cranberry juice.
Yeah, it's
true.
It is. It's Yeah.
And even if it's not,
cranberry,
that's what we say. So.
Pomegranate, all of those are like super fruits.
Yes, they the red fruits.
Yep.
Yep. That's the truth.
Yeah.
Terry, that was so good.
So the festival, when they take the cranberries, they make everything they can think of in out of cranberries.
Right.
So they've got, you know, the typical, the bread. Mm-hmm. But then she said they put it in brats, and they do, every year they try to figure out, kind of like the steak fair, what can we do different this year? So you just never know what you're going to find.
That sounds like fun.
Although, are you a big cranberry guy?
When, yeah, I would.
I know, but like when you just take them out of the can and you for like Thanksgiving and cut them up.
Oh, I love those.
Did you?
Yeah, because, you know, we ate all that crap at home.
Okay.
You know?
I did too. But it wasn't one of those things you'd clamor for. But
no,
when you'd go to someplace else, they'd have it where it's like mixed in with like oranges and stuff.
Like an actual cranberry relish.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah. That's good when they mix it with the oranges. Yeah,
that's phenomenal.
Cranberry relish.
Cranberry relish.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, because cranberries were always.
Listen to you.
But you gotta admit, cranberries when we were kids were always eaten by the old people.
Absolutely. That's what I mean.
Not a kid's food.
It's like you take them because it was there.
Grandma put them on the table.
Exactly.
Take one, Jimmy.
You just take one slice and that was it. Yeah. It's kind of like
they plop it on your plate and say, "Eat it anyway."
Yeah, we did that. But
okay,
anyway,
same here.
That sounds like a lot of fun because, you know, we talked about, we had the people on here, I think from Seymour, they had the big hamburger festival.
Yeah.
It's cool when a community that's small like that, it has some, you know, statewide and even larger than that exposure. That's,
you know,
very
what's kind
cool.
of sad? I just read an article about Two Rivers. This is their last Kite Fest.
Yes.
Kite Soho.
Why?
Yeah. Well, they had to move it to Two Rivers High School because the beach has gotten so small at Neshoto.
Oh, yeah.
And I want to say 19 years or something.
Yeah.
That was a really popular thing.
Yeah. They've got a lot going on, though. Two Rivers has more than one thing, but this Warren sounds like cranberries is their thing. And they got that sauerkraut festival, right? Isn't that right up the road here? And like, I don't know.
Whatever. Oh, yeah. It's got to be.
Yeah, it does. It is. That's
Creek?
A big deal.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure it's Black Creek, yeah.
Hey, well, Terry Barr, that was outstanding. Great stuff.
Thank you, dear.
Thank you for making our show.
Yeah, thanks for that. Yeah,
that was phenomenal. And get him on our air if you can.
If you get that contact, I'd love to thank him for that.
I will talk with him. He's in Europe for the next couple of months. I'll talk to him soon.
Ask him if he'll do a song about me.
We'll
thanks,
with
Terry
the
Barr. Back after this.
Presley wanted to ride. He wrote it all night, a week before he died.
Hey, welcome back. Mine on the Mayor. Oh, we got to do our contest. Todd, what's our prize package? How many quarters I found in my car that I salvaged yesterday?
That's
how about
right.
we give? Let's do a 50-50. Give half to the winner and half goes to our quarters for guests. Or you want to give it all to them? Or you want to give them something else? I don't care. I just, let's.
Well, you've got t-shirts, right? I've got some tickets for Let Me Be Frank Productions for their next show.
Oh,
so
that would
got
be
that.
Phenomenal.
Here are tickets for that.
What is this next one?
I think it's got a Christmas one coming up soon.
Soon?
Believe it or not. I mean, think about it. We're already in fall, so they're thinking ahead to that.
Okay. Wow.
Wow.
Okay, so you're going to guess how many quarters.
I found in my car.
The dollar amount, okay?
Oh, the dollar
amount. I thought it was going to be the exact number of quarters.
Then we'll divide by four, John.
Okay.
You know.
Yeah. So in dollars, how much did we find without going over, just like the Price is Right?
Yeah. In Mino's car.
In Mino's car.
And how many of them actually had to be pried out of a thing?
out of the Sticking actual, together.
With a screwdriver because they were stuck together from the sodas that I've spilt in there.
So you can text on the Civic Media app, download it, choose WGBW or WISS, lower right-hand corner, your guess for the dollar amount of quarters that we found in Mino's car.
And then also, like I said, I got it salvaged yesterday down in Newton, and they had a big job application thing for a heavy equipment operator for the crane.
Magnets and the
cranes. And I would like to know where I can go to school to get a degree in that, because I would like that job very much.
Yeah, I don't know that it requires a lot of schooling, quite honestly. Right? You're picking up a car and you're dropping it in a condenser.
I would love to watch that, though.
Oh, yeah.
Wouldn't that be cool?
Awesome.
I would love that.
And then, you know, I bet the guys who clean out the cars, you know.
Well, it has to be cleaned out when you bring it in.
So they don't lie. I thought maybe the guys would find cool stuff.
Wonder why that is.
I don't know. But they have it right on the form. Was the car cleaned out? I mean, it's a vacuum or anything, but no other stuff.
Well, that would be the first.
Yeah. Oh my God. It was so, when I got rid of, when I stepped out of the car, it's like, see ya. You know, sometimes you, you sell a car. And
it's, oh, you get it sentimental.
Great
right.
memories.
Yeah.
I have no good memories in that car. None. It's not easy, a single one.
Easier to get rid of.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh, so we're talking, you know, the Zip and Pippin, that guy, those seats are very narrow, you know, because we, the country's gotten much larger since that ride was out there. And it's,
well, Elvis was sitting in there. It couldn't have been.
Yeah, I was going to say, he must have
had his own car.
They had to modify that because that is pretty tight. And but we're talking about, John's getting back on his diet today.
And I'm going to go to the Croc Center. Not today, but I'm going to start working out at the Croc Center. What?
Okay. That would be great. You know what?
And I'm going to learn how to do the thing where you're running through the streets of Italy.
And it's free.
Yeah.
It's for you, because for people who are on Medicare, they give you a number. It's called Silver Sneakers number. And you can only do it at one health club, but you can take it to the Y, you can take it to
that makes me sound so old, it's unbelievable.
I know. See, I'm one of those, and you can take it anywhere, and they put your number in there. Now I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think you have to use it.
Well, I'm going to use it.
No, I hope the government.
How old would you think you were if you didn't know how old you were?
31.
Come on.
Yeah, I say that all the time.
31.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. I think.
Really?
I mean, I'm not,
that's
I was
wonderful.
31.
I think it's great.
When I was 31, you guys, I felt bulletproof.
You were the crap, as they would say.
Say something like that.
Yeah.
I think I was 45.
Okay. Yeah. That's cool.
That's me too. Yep.
I think I'm still more of a risk taker. At 45, I think I chilled a little bit. I don't know if I did or not. But though 31 was, I was recently married, had a kid, started my own business, and I liked that time in my life. I had no money, but it was like just a cool, cool time in my life.
All right.
I liked it. I liked it a lot.
All right.
So
we got a winner this morning.
Oh, wow. Okay. I didn't even know there was an answer.
I don't even know the answer.
Neither do I.
I've got the answer right here in front of me.
All right.
Some of the guesses that came in this morning include $5. Dave guessed that one. William guessed $7. And Nancy guessed $6.75. All relatively close.
Okay? Yeah.
The amount of money that John Mino found in his car, all quarters, by the way, before turning it into the salvage company, total was $9 exactly.
Wow.
$9. Wow. All right. Well, there. That's good.
Wow, 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 wow.
Changes in a plastic bag in Amanda's office now. Yeah. So get extra parking money.
Wow. And they win Frank tickets?
We're going to send them T-shirts and Frank tickets and all that good stuff.
Nice.
So congratulations, Sharon of Green Bay.
Congratulations, Sharon.
36 quarters all over the place, too,
all
right?
All over,
it was
every
just,
place.
It wasn't like it was in one little container.
No, under floor mats, in the ashtray, in the little thing that you always open up and put stuff in. I found so much. I found like four or five flashlights, found a knife, found two locks. I don't know why I had two locks in there.
Wow.
I'm serious. I mean, it's amazing the stuff I found in there. Wow. Yeah. Yeah.
That's amazing that I wouldn't have guessed you had that much, because sometimes you go through your car to look for quarters like to get a cheeseburger or something like that. You know, it's like, there's got to be enough money in this car. So,
Do you remember when you were searching your car under the seat, Jim, to find the checkbook that time?
Right.
He
didn't have any cash.
I didn't have any cash. I know there's a checkbook in his car somewhere. So it was under like the floor.
Still not as bad as the time on that really hot day. We went to that benefit and between the two of us could not afford one beer. Yeah. And it was at a brewery and everybody else was drinking craft beer and we're drinking water.
We walked up there, the guy was, how much is the beer? $4. We look at each other like, no, we don't have it. Between us, we had like $2.25.
Yeah.
So,
honest to God, no lie. And we literally went over to the water container. Oh, everybody else had these beautiful glasses of craft
and we took
beer.
That little cup you pee in and put water in there, and that's what we had.
But,
And
that's
those guys
not
are doing all right.
You know, you've made it in life when that's your life
that's
story right,
right
there.
Yeah.
So much better now.
Yeah, that was 4 months ago. Great show today, Todd. Great guests.
Yeah, good stuff. Fun.
What do we got coming up tomorrow? Do you know?
Yeah. Let's see. Coming up tomorrow, we've got Mandy Wilkie, the area manager for Stroll Ledgeview, stopping by.
Yeah, great.
And Ted Stefaniak's going to join us from TV32 Sports Showdown to talk about the matchup.
That's right. We got a great game tomorrow night. Bayport against Kimberly on a Thursday night, which is different but fun.
Why is it?
I don't know.
Oh, it's Thursday because Friday's the Packers.
No.
Is it the refs and stuff like that just needing enough refs?
I don't know. I really and truly don't know. This is the only time I think we've ever had one on a Thursday. I really don't know the reason.
But next week it's on a Thursday too, right? Because of the Packer game?
There's going to be one where we don't have a game.
Next week is no game.
Right.
Oh, there's
right.
no yeah. game.
Yes.
Wow.
Because of the Packer game.
Yeah.
And nobody wanted to go on to Thursday, I guess, for that one. So, yeah. So we're just going to go with that.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
All right, that'd be fun.
I'm looking forward to that game, though, the Packer game.
Oh, yeah, on Friday night.
It's been a long time since I've been really, really excited about a Packer opener.
Because of Philly or because
of being in Brazil. Just curious to see all the fans react and everything like
that. Did he say they had...
Has there ever been one in South America before?
I'm not sure.
Did Aaron say... We talked about that yesterday, I think, on our show that, I don't know, is there 30 million fans
down
there?
Oh, yeah, he said that. It's like 30 million football fans. Wow. Mind-boggling.
We just want a dollar from each of you, so, wow.
Yeah, but you know what? Everything's not financial with us.
Not at all.
No, that's not financial.
We're playing just exposure.
Yeah. Hey, thanks, everybody, for tuning in. We'll be back again tomorrow morning. My name is Mayor. See ya. Zip it to the left. Zip it to the right. Zip on, boom, boom.